To the maternal and paternal descendants of World War I veterans. The descendants have been taught drill today by Mr. Bob Gerson and Lieutenant Glenn Carr. Their training corps cadets led and followed the descendants as they marched onto the parade ground this morning. The cadets are carrying five Australian flags and five New Zealand flags. Each flag represents one decade since the commencement of World War I and the formation of ANZAC. The first Australians wounded in World War I were Able Seaman Bill Williams and Captain Dr. Brian Ponting. The medallions the descendants will be presented with carry the images of Able Seaman Williams and Captain Dr. Ponting. Both Williams and Botley succumbed to their wounds later that day and became Australia's first casualties serving with Australian forces in World War I. Among the recipients today is the family of John Hamilton VA, from the family of John Edwards, who served on the AE2. AE2 was the only Royal Australian naval vessel to be lost as a result of enemy action during World War I. And along with the sister boat AE1, the total of the Royal Australian Navy's operational losses in the war. The descendants are being presented their medallions by Rear Admiral Stuart Mann, the Honourable Bronwyn Bishop MP, Captain David Elliott MP, Brigadier Catherine Campbell, and Major General Warren Glenn. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now the descendants have been presented with their medallions, they'll march off with their Air Force cadets leading. Ladies and gentlemen, just before the parade commences, we have the troops holding ground coming into position on what is now parade ground. Most of the vehicles are on display today, the armoured vehicles, are the Australian Armoured Vehicle Association, a group of current and former service personnel and civilian enthusiasts who own, restore and display military vehicles. In 1996, a group of armoured vehicle enthusiasts, many being former Armoured Corps troops, decided to pool their resources and formed the Australian Armoured Vehicles Association. They're led by two Ferret Scout cars, a Saladin armoured car, and a Saracen armoured personnel carrier bringing up the rear. Those vehicles will hold ground for the duration of the parade. And on their way to escort the Governor of New South Wales, the Light Horse Escort. And the salutes being taken by Rear Admiral Stuart Mayer. Gentlemen, the New South Wales Corrective Services Band leads the Parade Command Group, the Royal Australian Naval Reserve, and the 2nd Division. The parade commander today is Lieutenant Colonel John Howells. The parade is being led by the National and New South Wales Chairman, the Honourable Tim Fisher, himself a former National Service Officer and platoon commander with the 1st Royal Australian Regiment in South Vietnam. Marching with him is the Deputy Chairman, Lieutenant Colonel John Moore. The parade RSM is Warrant Officer Class 1, Chris Guest. Thank you. The 2nd Division was formed in Egypt and served with distinction in Gallipoli and on the battlefields of France and Belgium. Its contribution resulted in the awarding of 13 Victoria Crosses. The division is holding its centenary parade on Friday the 24th of this July in front of the Australian War Memorial. Since its establishment, members of the 2nd Division have served in every major theatre of operation from Gallipoli on. Naval Reserve formation is being led by their President, Lieutenant Commander Beverly Stewart, Royal Australian Naval Reserve. The 5th Infantry Brigade is being led by former commander of the brigade, Colonel Don Tate, and the RSM is Sean Parker. The brigade was formed in 1915 with 4 battalions and it served in Gallipoli and on the Western Front, taking part in the major battles in Somme and Flanders. It's an operational brigade of armour, engineers and infantry with other supporting arms and services and is part of the 2nd Division. Now the band of the 1st 15th Royal New South Wales Lancers. Come on, yeah, Tom. The parade RSM will now hand over to the parade commander, who will prepare the parade to receive the official guests. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Chief of the Defence Force and Chief of Navy, Rear Admiral Stuart Mayer.
Parade! Carry standards! Parade! General salute! Salute!
representing the Premier of New South Wales, Captain David Elliott, MP.
Brave General Salute! Salute!
Representing the Prime Minister and Minister for Defence, the Honourable Bronwyn Bishop, MP.
Pray! General Sloan! Sloan! Pray! Attend! Hunt! Standard bearers carry standards! Pray! Standard!
The parade now awaits the arrival of the Governor of New South Wales.
Parade, attend, halt!
Ladies and gentlemen, the parade will now receive the Honourable General David Hurley, Governor of New South Wales, accompanied by Mrs. Linda Hurley. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand?
Troop will advance to half section. Walk! March!
Ladies and gentlemen, a new standard will be uncased today, commemorating the centenary of the landings of Gallipoli in 1915. Gallipoli standard bearer is Captain Mike Fitzgerald, Royal Australian Signals Corps. He is a member of one of three heritage organisations involved today, the Australian Federation Troop, the 18th Battalion Living History Group, and the Australian Great War Association. These people are living history groups and are dressed in the uniforms worn by members of the 1st AIF at Gallipoli.
Uncase the standard.
Flagpoles opposite the Gallipoli Standard, the flags of Australia and New Zealand, are being unfurled to commemorate a centenary of Anzac. Anzac Gallipoli Standard will be now paraded into its place on the parade ground. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my pleasure to introduce the National Chairman of the Reserve Forces Day Council, the Honourable Tim Fisher.
Thank you very much indeed, Robert Morrison, Excellencies, Reservists, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, everybody, to this parade in the centenary year of ANZAC. And to our MC, who's come up from Canberra year after year, I think a special round of applause to Rob Morrison on my left, doing a great job with everybody else. Well done. And welcome is the New South Wales patron, State Governor of New South Wales, returning His Excellency General, the Honourable David Hurley, ACDSC, and Mrs. Hurley, to this, the Reserve Forces' 17th year. The 64th year of the RAC being formed and many other women's units, and of course the 100th year of ANZAC. I should also say we're very pleased to have several other key guests, but you are all guests. The Honourable Bronwyn Bishop, Speaker of the House of Representatives, officially representing the Honourable the Prime Minister, Tony Abbott, and the Honourable Kevin Andrews, Minister for Defence. The Honourable David Elliott, Member for Baulkham Hills, Minister for Veterans Affairs and one or two other portfolios, and Minister Anthony Roberts from the New South Wales State Government, and David representing the Premier. Rear Admiral Stuart Mayer, CSC, and Bar, Royal Australian Navy Fleet Commander, representing the Chief of the Defence Force, Chief of the Navy, and he almost captured the US Blue Ridge last night. He was on board for 90 minutes, cased the place, and nearly pulled it off. Mr. Sean McGean and Mrs. Janet Barclay, New Zealand Consul, representing the New Zealand Consul General, the representatives of all the services, the emergency services, police, fire and rescue, New South Wales Ambulance and the SES. You have all done us proud being here today. And I want to thank our sponsors and supporters. They're listed in your program, as well as the various messages of support we have received. The parade acknowledges the formation of the ANZAC and the Gallipoli campaign, and it's pleasing to see the Australian and the New Zealand flags flying together on this day. And we should not forget there are other members of the Commonwealth who performed on that invasion and the Dardanelles, including 1,000 Indians who lost their lives and two Canadian nurses who died on nearby Lemnos Island. The Gallipoli campaign had a high number of reserve officers, including senior commanders and NCOs, among them Brigadier John Monash, promoted Brigadier 100 years ago this month of July on the beach at Gallipoli shortly after his 50th birthday, and arguably our greatest World War I commander. Right through to Matron Margaret Wilson on Lemnos Island within gun hearing range, and later she performed on the Western Front and set the pattern of so many of the women of this nation and New Zealand who also served and who we hope to salute further in our parades of next year. It is a pleasure, I'm sure, for all of the presenters and medallions and war bars to acknowledge the service of the members of their families from which they're descended with the medallions that they were presented today. And that included the descendants of a Victorian Cross recipient and a descendant of members of the submarine AE2. You'll see many of those descendants having marched past. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted as National Chair, New South Wales Chair, to welcome you all on this splendid Sydney 5th of July, to salute all that are on parade, on a job outstanding in Newcastle yesterday and here in Sydney today, to salute John Moore and the huge team behind the scenes that makes it all possible, and to introduce to you, firstly, to read a message from the Prime Minister. Would you please welcome the Honourable the Speaker of the House of Representatives, the Honourable Bronwyn Bishop.
Your Excellency and parliamentary colleagues, but all distinguished guests, but particularly those who have marched today, the Prime Minister has asked me to read his message to you today because he believes, as I do, that we must always remember the service and the sacrifice that has made this country the country it is today. And as we presented those medallions at the beginning of today's proceedings, they were the descendants of those people who were the survivors, those people who came home and continued to build the nation. But we lost so many who never married, who didn't have families, so many women who never equally were able to marry and have families. And whereas we were able to see children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren, we must always remember that that service and sacrifice meant that many, 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 many people were lost to us as future citizens. And so the Prime Minister has written, "I am pleased to provide this message for the 2015 National Reserve Forces Day Parade. For over 100 years, reservists of the Navy, Army and Air Force have been an essential part of the Australian Defence Force. Wherever they have fought, reservists have embodied the commitment to freedom, the devotion to country and the bonds of mateship that we hold dear. Their courage and sacrifice leave us the enduring legacy of a free and peaceful nation, and their example is emulated by all who serve our country today. Today's National Reserve Forces Day Parade honours their service with a particular tribute to the ANZAC who fought at Gallipoli. Throughout the Gallipoli campaign, our forebears faced trials scarcely imaginable to those who had left behind. Some 750 Australians were killed on the day of the Gallipoli landing, and more than 8,700 Australians would lose their lives before the evacuation. Out of this baptism of fire, former reservist captain Alfred Shout, VCMC, became Australia's most decorated Gallipoli veteran. Though he lost his life, Shout's example endures as a reminder of the courage and sacrifice exemplified by many ex-reservists who formed an important part of the first AIF. This Reserve Forces Day, we honour all former and serving reservists and share a sense of pride in all who have served our country. Lest we forget, Tony Abbott, MP, Prime Minister of Australia."
Thank you to the Speaker, and thank you for the message from Prime Minister Tony Abbott, who did also try and conquer Blue Ridge a couple of days ago. This is still unfinished business. Ladies and gentlemen, I now have great pleasure in welcoming the State Governor of the oldest state of this realm, the State Governor of the State of New South Wales, His Excellency General the Honourable David Hurley. The Honourable Tim Fisher, the New South Wales and National Chairman of the Reserve Forces State Council, to Lieutenant Colonel John Moore, the National Executive Officer and the New South Wales Deputy Chairman of this Council, to Mr. Sean McCain and Ms. Gemma Barclay, the New Zealand Consulate, representing the New Zealand Consul General, the Honourable Bronwyn Bishop, Speaker of the House of Representatives, representing the Honourable Tony Abbott, MP, Prime Minister of Australia, the Honourable David Elliott, MP, Minister for Veteran Affairs, Corrections and Emergency Services, himself a reservist, representing the Honourable Mike Baird, Premier of New South Wales, Rear Admiral Stuart Mayer, commanding of the Australian Fleet, representing the Chief of Defence Force. Ladies and gentlemen, a great honour and a great distinction for me to be here for my first Reserve Forces Day parade as the Governor of New South Wales, although I have been here on a number of times with my former guise as Chief of the Defence Force. This is the first Reserve Forces Day, as I say, as Governor. I'm honoured to be here and to host the launch event, as I did for this year's Reserve Forces Day at Government House earlier in the year. Firstly, I would like to pay my respects to the traditional owners of the land on which we gather, the Gadigal of the Eora Nation. I acknowledge their living culture and affirm my respect for their elders, ancestors and descendants. I'd also like to acknowledge our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander comrades who were present in every Defence Force campaign of our nation. Earlier this year, I was privileged to unveil the new War Memorial in Imagimini here in Hyde Park. It sits alongside our own Anzac War Memorial and honours the service of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders men and women who have made such a significant contribution to the Australian Defence Force. I would also like to acknowledge our New Zealand comrades who are with us today and have fought with us through thick and thin from the First World War onwards. We recognise this long-lasting and unbreakable connection, this brotherhood and sisterhood almost in blood, through our new Anzac Gallipoli standard, uncased and paraded for the first time today, and our flag bearers, five Air Force cadets from each country representing the 10 decades since 1915. This year's commemoration has been given even more poignancy by the presentation earlier today, as we mentioned, of medallions with the War Bar Gallipoli to the descendants of the members of the 1st Australian Imperial Force who served at Gallipoli. In some cases, they are representing their veteran and relative who did not return. Today is an occasion in which we recognise and appreciate the esprit de corps of our reserve forces and affirm on behalf of all the people of New South Wales our gratitude to them. 100 years ago, as we landed at Gallipoli, our vast but sparsely populated country of just 4.5 million people became embroiled in a global war. At the commencement of the First World War, the militia, or as we know them today, reservists, played a critical role in the raising of the 1st Australian Imperial Force, given the majority of officers and the significant number of non-commissioned officers in service. Our reservists have also undertaken peacekeeping and humanitarian activities in overseas settings, where multiple skills are required in addition to their military rigour, their professionalism and their courage. This year has seen our reserve forces deployed in emergency relief and humanitarian work in Vanuatu and in Queensland after devastating cyclones. In diverse areas across our troubled world, places far from home, places of anticipated and unanticipated danger, reservists are fulfilling a valuable role in our defence force. And indeed, they are serving in places of most danger today in Afghanistan, Africa and the Middle East. The reservist role is a demanding one, undertaking voluntary work, yet integrated with everyday responsibilities, including work as doctors to teachers, lawyers to self-employed tradesmen, in the police force and in a multitude of other occupations, and trying to integrate family life alongside this added commitment to nation. We particularly thank their families for their past and continued support. Our current issues of defence and security in these turbulent times require that the training and fitness of Australian reservists match the levels of the military personnel in our regular forces. Indeed, I recently visited Battle Group Waratah, consisting primarily of New South Wales reservists, on exercise in Shoalwater Bay about 2 weeks ago, and doing a tremendous job. 540 members of that battle group. It is a tribute to the men and women of the reserve forces that this day of commemoration and respect is celebrated across our continent, raising in the minds and hearts of our citizens our debt to the Army, Navy and Air Force Reserve and to the families and employers who give so much valued support. They have served our nation with distinction for 100 years and they will continue to do so. Congratulations to you and to all those represented on the parade today and to all those who work so hard to put this parade together. Well done and thank you. We thank the State Governor for his very comprehensive and pertinent message in regard to reservists and invite the preparations for the National Anthem. Please, another round of applause for the State Governor of New South Wales, Honourable David Hurley. Again, our thanks, and as we
we move to the next stage of the ceremony. I've been asked to invite you to consider three cheers to our reservists, putting their lives at risk and blending so well with our professional Navy, Army and Air Force. And as we do, you think back over that 100 years and to all who have served at all ranks, private, corporal, leading airman, able seaman, through to our three Australian field marshals, Birdwood 1925, Blaney 1950, and Prince Philip 1954, made an Australian field marshal. So we have an enormous cacophony, but we salute our reservists today with three cheers. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Thank you very much.
Standard bearers, carry standards!
Ladies and gentlemen, the vocalists from the band of the 1st 15th Royal New South Wales, the regiment, musician Elizabeth Smith, will now sing We Are Australian. Elizabeth Smith and the band of the 1st 15th Royal New South Wales Lancers.
Pray! Vice Regal salute! Salute! the light horse.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the light horse escort to His Excellency will now rank past and give His Excellency an eye's right. Ladies and gentlemen, that parade will now march off, and as they do so, they will pass the dais and give His Excellency an eye's right. Thank you.
gentlemen, that concludes today's Reserve Forces Day parade. And on behalf of the Reserve Forces Day Council, thank you for your attendance and your attention.